Hi, my name is Wanchao Liang, and I'm from the PyTorch Distributed team at Meta. Today, we're going to present our recent work about two-dimensional parallelism using Distributed Tensor. We will briefly go through the background and motivation, then introduce the Distributed Tensor concept, and the tensor parallelism that builds on top of Distributed Tensor. Then, we will go through the 2D parallelism that we built for the vision transformer model. Let's briefly talk about the background and motivation. Currently, the research community train large-scale models mainly in three ways: data parallel, within-layer model parallel, and pipeline parallel. In PyTorch, for data parallel, we are offering distributed data parallel and fully sharded data parallel to train large-scale models. For pipeline parallel, we are offering PP or pipeline parallel solution, which is currently in the prototype stage. So, what should be a general purpose within layer model parallelism look like? Our answer to this is distributed tensor and the tensor parallelism that's built on top of it. So, what is distributed tensor? Distributed tensor, also known as D-tensor, is a common abstraction we proposed to build a bridge between different parallelism strategies. It offers fundamental tensor-level primitives to describe data distribution and computation across hosts. D-tensor consists of two important concepts. The first concept is device mesh, an abstraction that describes the topology of devices within a cluster. For example, we could construct a device mesh that describes two hosts, each with two GPUs. The second concept is the D-tensor placement types. There are three placement types: shard, where we shard on tensor dimension across devices; replicate, where we replicate tensor across devices; partial, where we partition values across devices. With these two concepts, we can distribute a tensor in different ways. For example, we can shard a tensor with each piece on separate devices, we can replicate a tensor across all devices, or we can even shard a tensor on a set of devices, then replicate this sharded tensor on another set of devices. Given the D-tensor concepts, now let's look at the D-tensor API. D-tensor is fundamentally a torsional tensor subclass, and it really looks like a normal tensor, except that it's distributed across devices. With a device mesh, we can create a D-tensor with row-wise sharding and column-wise sharding, and we can convert from or to local torsional tensor on each rank. We can re-shard or redistribute a D-tensor from one type of sharding to another. We also offer high-level API to shard and scatter an existing tensor from one rank to all other ranks. With the power of D-tensor, we can build tensor parallelism APIs on top of it to express model parallelism. Next, I will hand it off to my teammate Junjie to talk about tensor parallelism and 2D parallel.
Hi, I'm Junjie Wang, and I will talk about tensor parallelism and its user API. First of all, let's see how tensor parallelism works. There are three parallelism styles we support: column-wise, row-wise, and pairwise parallelisms. The first two are pretty intuitive, as we just partition one dimension of a given tensor. The third one, pairwise parallelism, is to combine the first two and achieve calculation efficiency. Let's take a look at the diagram below. As you can see here, after multiplying with the first column-wise partitioned linear, we don't need to do any collective and leave the activation partitioned. And this partition matrix can then do another multiplication with a row-wise partitioned linear directly. To get the final result, we just need to do one RReduce here. When it comes to API, users don't need to change their module or code. They just need to call this high-level API parallelize module with parallelize style specified per module to get the model partitioned. We will handle all the hassles during model training and inference. Next, I want to talk about 2D parallelism, where we combine data parallel and tensor parallel together. The way it works is that we first partition each model parameter across all GPUs on each host, and then the fully sharded data parallel, which is also called FSDP, will reshard the local tensor of tensor parallelism. This way, we can get the benefits of both tensor parallel and data parallel. The user API is also pretty simple. That user just need to create a 2D device mesh before calling the parallelized module API, and user can then wrap the model with FSDP. Last but not least, I want to talk about what preliminary result we have got so far from the experiment on the VIT model. We see 2.6 times faster in training a 60 billion VIT model and enable the training of a 120 billion VIT model on 64 GPUs. Here, we can do some back-of-envelope calculations. If we simplify each layer of transformer encoder as one input tensor and four linears, we can calculate the peak memory ratio for 2D parallelism and FSDP-only scenarios. The result shows that when the batch size is 1024, FSDP is using 1.3 times more peak memory than 2D parallelism. And upon measurement, this ratio is 1.1. Meanwhile, if we reduce the batch size to 512, this ratio increases to 2.4. The result shows that when the batch size is 1024, FSDP is using 1.3 times more peak memory than 2D parallelism. And upon measurement, this ratio is 1.1. Meanwhile, if we reduce the batch size to 512, the ratio increases to 2.4. This calculation shows that when the number of GPUs is limited, and if we have to use small batch size for really large model, 2D parallelism can indeed have some advantages.